These are a list of stocks over which Macquarie currently has issued warrants. Hopefully I get time to look at most of the ones that are highlighted in yellow. The reason I've highlighted them in yellow is that they are typical examples of particular opportunities or types of opportunities in the current market. Doesn't mean they're the best, and some have developed beyond that, but I want to examine the types of opportunities. So, AirAsia, key factor, and I'm not going to ask you, I'm going to move through it quickly. Long-term group of moving averages, well separated. Tells us there is strong investor support for AirAsia. Short-term group of averages, also widely separated. Tells us that traders are also very confident. So when price pulls back, as it did to $3.90 and $4, it is a safe opportunity to go in as a buyer for a continuation of the long-term uptrend. So we don't see any weakness in this type of chart. And there are lots of other stocks in that group that have similar GMMA relationships. That's the key to look for. It tells us that when price dropped back to $4.15 the other day, and this I did these charts 3 days ago, that was a buy opportunity for AirAsia. That the price is likely to continue its trend. There is no method that we can use to set upside targets with that. It's simply buy, go long, hold on, and count your money. CIMB, similar situation, but notice with CIMB that the degree of separation between the long-term group and the short-term group is not as consistent. We've had that pullback that developed that dropped price down to 690, 680. The short-term group, the traders also sell off in that environment. We're not quite as bullish on CIMB for that reason. It's still a good buying opportunity because it hasn't really penetrated the long-term group. It's still widely separated. We go into that, but we would set our initial resistance targets at around 745, near those two twin peaks that are there. A break above that 745 target gives us, you measure the width of that from 7 to 750, gives an upside target around $8. So it's still a strong uptrend, but is not as strong as AirAsia. A shorter term trading opportunity. Dialogue. Anyone got Dialogue? Good luck. With Dialogue, what we're seeing is a trend that's weakening. First, the long-term group is still widely separated, so that's a positive, that's bullish. But the degree of separation between the long-term group and the short-term group has disappeared. If you're looking at this period from December through to mid-January, good, solid, stable trend. But then what's happened is the short-term group has come back and closed that gap between the long-term group and the short-term group. The short-term group is not widely separated. Traders are not particularly bullish in this environment. And that's a note of caution. Remember, AirAsia, they were widely separated. They were very bullish. CIMB, pretty widely separated, also bullish. Here, they're not so sure. So what do they know that we don't? That's the first question I ask. Secondly, we have a number of penetrations into the long-term group. That's like walking past a construction site. You know, they're all sitting there with jackhammers. Bang, 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 bang. Large, large chunks of rock. And they just keep on hitting it, just a little bit. Bang, 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 and eventually the rock cracks. It's exactly the same process that takes place in the market. Here, we've got the market hitting, penetrating that lower edge of the GMMA, bouncing back, hitting it again, bouncing it back. That is the first indications of weakness within the uptrend. This constant hammering on that support level will eventually collapse it. And when that collapse takes place, it's often very, very rapid. If it was, where would we set the downside targets? If it broke through below 255 today, where's the next logical support level on this chart? Anyone like to give me a figure? Okay, 225. If you look at 225, draw a cross, you can see that it's acted as a resistance level. The market's moved up, pulled back, moved up, pulled back, back here in October, November. And then back here at the end of November, it's acted as a support level. So the high probability is that if the market, if it falls below 260, the lower edge of long-term GMMA, it's most likely to fall back to around the 235 level. So for me, this environment, and this environment sets a potential short opportunity. I don't want to be it from the long side in new positions because there's that trend weakness there. There are better opportunities in trend strength for those relationships with Air Asia, with CIMB. Now, it doesn't mean I'm right. I hope I am, but it doesn't mean I'm right. It's just the way that I apply GMMA analysis to help me to decide how to trade. GD Express. You know what GD Express stands for? Express way to lose money. It's not going anywhere. There is no strong uptrend. There's no strong downtrend. It's simply lazy money. And lazy money eventually dies in the market. The separation between the long-term and the short-term group, it's all over the place. There's no clear separation between long-term and short-term. There's no separation in either the long-term or short-term individual groups. So there's no strong trending behavior. It's sitting between 68 and 59. It might go up, it might go down, but that's not a way to make money. What we're looking for is stocks that have clear established trends which we can join for a continuation of that trend, or stocks where, for instance, the downtrend is clearly beginning to develop into an uptrend. So that's an example of what we need to avoid. It doesn't matter how good the company is, how effective we think it is, whether we've just had a two-day delivery from GD Express, which is really, really good, doesn't matter. From a trading perspective, the opportunity isn't there. Hibiscus. I have no idea how Hibiscus is going to develop. However, I'm in love with it already. Hibiscus has a classic bullish flag. In other words, a very fast rise from 76 to 105. That's not bad. Let's make, because the maths is easier, let's make it 75 to 105. That's a 30 cent rise. Then prices pull back, and that pullback is clearly defined by two parallel downward sloping trend lines. It's a bullish flag. So what happens with bullish flags? Bullish flags make you money about 85% of the time. In other words, when the price moves above that upper trend line, then it's most likely to continue. And it's likely to continue, in this case, to the value of about 30 cents. In other words, you measure the height of the flagpole, from 75 to 105, measure that height. Then, at the point at which price breaks above that upper trend line, project that value. That sets your upside target. Once that breakout takes place, there's about an 85% probability that upside target will be achieved. Can you make money between 95, what we say, what's 30? 95 and $1.25. Yeah, okay, la. But if I'm trading it as a warrant, then I can magnify that return 3, 4, 5 times depending on the size of the warrant. So this is a simple chart pattern. I love chart patterns. Chart patterns allow me to set very, very accurate stop-loss positions and targets. I can calculate risk and reward. This is not trading advice, by the way. It's just the way that I apply this analysis to this chart. I did think about actually getting rid of Hibiscus, but I think we'll be okay. How it develops, I don't know. Friday's trading, which is not on this chart, was inside of that flag. When do I abandon this? If this continues to pull back to around the 87 mark, I'm out of the trade because flags don't go on forever. They're a relatively short-term phenomenon. So I'd give this another 3 to 4 days. If it hasn't broken on the upside, I'm not interested in the trade. But if it breaks on the upside on Monday, then I will trade it through to the height of that flagpole projected upwards. Carex, please, please tell me that you are short. It's got all the classic conditions we need to go for short. Long-term group, widely separated. Investors hate this stock. They will sell it down every opportunity they have. Short-term group, does anyone own Carex here, by the way? Are you sure? Okay. You only will trade this from the short side. The separation between the long-term group and short-term group, consistent. No one's interested in trying to build this stock up or change its trend. It broke through key support at $1.16 and created a new support at $1.05. Let's say $1.15, $1.05 makes life easy. 10 cents. Therefore, our downside target is 95, trading band already achieved. Next downside target would be 85. Trading band analysis is projecting downwards. So it's a short trading environment. It doesn't matter when people are saying this is an excellent stock, it's due for a rebound, management is fully confident, etc., etc. This chart is telling you, run quickly. Maybank, pretty strong. It's close to a breakout. So it's different from CIMB, different from Air Asia. It had that pullback that took place in reaction to international concerns. So we can sort of dismiss that. Underlying trend is strong. We're looking for a pullback, probably towards the lower edge of the short-term GMMA. Notice that that's where it's been tested frequently. So a pullback to around $1.03 or $1.04 is a buying opportunity for a continuation of that uptrend. So Icon, this is a classic rollover. If you're going short, this is a short trading environment. Long-term group has turned over and compressed. Investors are selling. Short-term group has already moved below the long-term group, a classic change of trend environment. If you were long on Sunway, Sunway Construction, then you would now be short. Uchitech. Any open positions on Uchitech? Pity, I was about to congratulate you. Okay, GMMA relationship's the key factor. Short-term group, compressed, turned up, wide separation. Traders, smart traders, are thinking this has got some future. This trend is likely to continue to develop. Look at the long-term group. Compressed, not fully, but it is compressing and turning up. Investors are beginning to believe that this stock is also on the upside. We can apply a count-back line analysis to this and use that for a stop loss. If we draw just a simple straight edge trend line from the high at $3.55 connecting with the high at $3.30, then we can see that it's a trend line break. So we've got a number of factors that tell us that this is a trend line break from down to up, that it has a high probability of success, that it's well supported by traders and increasingly well supported by investors. So this is a breakout environment, a breakout situation. Upside target, initial target is that small resistance level at 330, 333. Beyond that, that triple top that created at 350. So we would trade this, taking entry at around $3 with an upside target around 350. Once it hits 350, we begin to tighten the stops to protect our profits, but the anticipation is that it would break past 350 and there is no way of setting a further upside target there. But the trade from 305, thereabouts, to 350, you can magnify the returns on that by using the leverage that's offered by the warrants that are covering it. We are well behind time, so I'm going to have to finish it here. When you're trading, remember this, Yanshan Bushishan. For those of you who can't read Chinese, the mountain you see is not the mountain. From a trading perspective, we think the mountain that we see is the fact that we can't predict the market. We don't know what's going to happen in the future. That despite all of our best analysis methods, we don't seem to get our prediction right. That's not the mountain. The mountain that you see, the problems that you see, that's not what stops you having trading success. Jianshan Bushishan. The mountain that really counts is the way that you set your stop losses, the way you calculate them, the way that you identify a balance of probability and understand what the market is telling you, not your colleagues, not the media, not what you see on CNBC or elsewhere. So I'll just leave you with that particular theme. Remember, and this reminds me of my grandson who is about to go to school. He thinks it's a big mountain, but it's not really. I wish you all the best in your trading. Thank you very much.